quarterback like Taysom Hill that can really run and do different things and can kind of keep plays alive a lot longer?
I know from the cornerback standpoint, you kind of just have to be good with your eyes, stay on the receiver as long as possible, not be looking in the backfield, peeking, things like that, because he can do so many different things, whether it's with his arm or with his legs. So just make doing our job, staying on Taz, you know what I'm saying, that kind of stuff.
They say he's just, like, freakishly strong. So with that in mind, how important is it for you guys to be really solid in tackling?
That's really important. I know on film he's been running guys over and things like that. So you just kind of have to bring your feet, not be afraid, just come up and be ready to hit them. Just win our one-on-one battles. Everybody do their job. They got both 2 6'6" receivers, so they're going to be looking to get them the ball because obviously they're taller than us. So a lot of jump ball situations. So just as long as our defensively we win those one-on-one battles, we should be fine.
Seems like you've had some pretty good competition amongst your position group during this fall camp.
Yeah, for sure. We have a lot of talented guys in our room, top to bottom, from the corners and the safety. So. It's a good problem to have because we got a lot of guys that could play and get on the field and not have too much of a drop off.
What sticks out about Matthews? He's one of those 6'6" guys in 900 yards last year, besides being tall. But what else has kind of jumped out at you from?
He has great ball skills. Attacks a ball at his highest point, which is extremely high when you're 6'6" and can jump. So things like that. He's a really good blocker. Pretty good route runner as well. Decisive speed, too. He kind of sneaks up on you with those long strides. So, you know, I've been watching him for a long time, so I kind of know what he does well.
What are the last 24 to 48 hours before an opener like as a player? I mean, what mindset are you trying to get in? What's that experience like?
It's extremely slow. Time goes by slow. You just kind of got to make sure you're in your film. You kind of know what to expect at that point. Just be ready for anything, any kind of trick play, things like that. You know, I stay with my iPad all day, so I kind of know what to expect.
So you don't want to get away from it at all? You stay?
Right, yeah, I just stay in tune with my studying and right before I go to sleep that night before.
How different are the philosophies from last year's staff to this year's staff?
I don't want to make it between last year and this year's staff, but schematically, it's I would say it's a little simpler, a little less reads, allows you to play a little bit more faster without having to look at too much, but you know, it makes us comfortable. That's probably the best way I could put it.
Daniel, you said that the wide receiver is so good at reaching the ball, it's not nice pulling. Mm-hmm.
Put your best athletes out there. I feel like me and Josh Kalu are pretty good in those one-on-one situations. We made those one-on-one plays in camp, so I feel like we're going to match up good because him and I are both pretty athletic, and we could jump pretty good, so I think we should be okay.
What's allowed Josh to rise up like he has so early in his career? You know, last year he had a black shirt and earning the role he has this season.
Really talented player. Josh just finds his way around the ball. Really good instincts. Probably not the fastest guy, but is really technically sound enough to where he could cover almost anybody. Really smart and ask questions. First one in the film room. He just does everything right. At the same time, making everybody laugh. So that's why we love Josh.
Mark Baker says he has a big personality effect. Sometimes he wants him to get a little more serious.
Yeah.
I
know last year they kind of got on him a little bit just because he was always joking on the field and everything, but he's kind of found that healthy balance this year where he knows when to do that and when it's time for business. So.
You've been around a lot of safeties now in Nebraska. How does Nathan stack up to the guys you played with the last 5 years?
Nate's just an all-around player. He could come up and hit you as well as play the ball in the air, make plays on the ball. Great leader, always getting us guys together and doing stuff, whether it's going to a movie, things like that. Just helping us be a close-knit group, which allows us to make plays, you know, as a unit. You know, he's going to have a great career here by the time it's all said and done. So that's probably the best thing.
Is there anything different about that opener versus other games, whether it's the motion or
You probably have a little butterflies and jitters and things like that, but after you get on the field for the first drive, after the first couple plays, you should be good and settled in, but you just kind of have to make sure you don't do anything outside of yourself and just try to play your game in that first opening. Expectations for this year, I just want to win them all. Take it one game at a time. I don't want to put a number on it and say I want to do this to this team or that to that team, but just take it one step at a time and win them all.